Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios, Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, and Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I was watching The Karate Kid the other day, and Daniel LaRusso was asking Mr. Miyagi when he was going to learn how to punch. Mr. Miyagi said he's got to learn balance first, because if LaRusso's balance is good, his karate will be good. That's why it's so remarkable to me when athletes are able to do things off balance. It's hard enough to get things right when you're under a sturdy foundation. Now when athletes are knocked off the puck or falling and still manage to get the job done, still manage to score, it's even that much more remarkable. Like Toronto's Auston Matthews did Sunday against Carolina. What a goal this was as he's hauled down and still puts it through Cam Ward's legs and into the net. Awesome, awesome goal. It's those kind of special plays from special players that bring fans of both sides out of their feet. So with that in mind, here are my top 10 falling down goals. At number 10, it's Mario the Magnificent. Lemieux has double-teamed his whole career, so it should come as no surprise he had to fight off a few checks to score goals. Here he goes right between Toronto's Boreas Salming and Rick Lance to beat Alan Bestard top corner while being hauled down. And here he's tripped by San Jose's Marty McSorley, but still manages to score on Chris Terreri. Only Mario could make falling down and scoring look so easy. Number 9, you don't earn a name like Stevie Wonder without being able to score some lovely goals. Yzerman was one of the best at not just scoring, but scoring incredible goals too. Look at Yzerman beat Sean Burke with a laser while falling against New Jersey. And here is this dandy versus Tom Barrasso and the Penguins for Yzerman's 400th career goal. Yeah, Barrasso waved at it, but it doesn't take anything away from Yzerman being able to get this shot off while falling. Awesome. Number 8, former Brandon Wheat King scoring star Eric Fair does his Mario Lemieux impression against the Bruins. Fair goes right between Dougie Hamilton and Dennis Seidenberg before going top corner on Tuukka Rask. Those Western League guys are the best. Number 7, another Western leaguer, this time tiny Tyler Ennis, pulls off some magic against the Habs. Ennis is steered away by Montreal's Alexa Yemlin as Ennis cuts to the net. Somehow the puck follows Ennis to the left side, and with his back to the net, Ennis fires a falling backhander past a stunned Carey Price. Number 6, Anaheim's Ryan Kesler gets a nice one against Phoenix. First, he turns Oliver Ekman-Larsson inside out, then he battles with Sam Gagner. Gagner brings Kesler down, but as he's falling, Kesler rips one past the blocker side of Mike Smith for an outstanding goal. I know it's hard to watch because of the uniforms, but check out Luke Robitaille's falling goal versus Calgary. Flames D-man Al MacInnis trips Robitaille going to the net, but Robitaille still swats the puck in past Mike Vernon, who can't believe it. It's a lucky thing. Lucky Luke scored this one because it makes looking at those hideous unis a little more tolerable in this clip. Number 4, Jaromír Jágr takes a pass up the ice, moves on the Flyers' goal, but is hauled down by Luke Richardson. As he's falling, Jágr shoots the puck and is stopped by Ron Hextall. But while he's on the ice, the rebound comes off the goalie, and from his back, Jágr bats the puck into the top corner. Although he was already down when he scored, his first shot occurred while he was falling, so I'm calling this a falling down goal. Number 3, Shediac, New Brunswick, Scott Pellerin scores the goal of his career against LA. Pellerin only had 10 goals in 92-93 when he got this one. Unbelievable goal. Kings goalie Rob Stauber comes out to challenge Pellerin because he sees the puck is in his skates. Amazing how the puck stays with Pellerin as he's head over heels and face in the ice as he sweeps it in. Incredible. And number 2, some plays just define a hockey player. They're so popular, everybody knows them, even if you're not a big hockey fan. This one by Alex Ovechkin is one of those goals. Scored in his rookie year, Ovi somehow puts this puck in past Brian Boucher and the Phoenix Coyotes. Paul Mara does his best to knock Ovi off the puck, but Ovechkin is too strong and manages to stay on his feet long enough to control the puck before he slides this one in. I don't think we'll ever see a goal like this again. I know it's not a goal, but I had to show this one because it's the best falling down play of all time. Look at Orr, surrounded by North Stars. Look at him keep his composure while he's falling to the ice. Watch what he does with the elbow. An unreal pass to Johnny Busick, who puts home one of his 556 goals. It's remarkable in slow motion, but let's see it again at game speed. Bobby Orr, the greatest hockey player ever, that's for sure. And the best falling down goal I've ever seen is a beauty from the 2009-2010 season when Steven Stamkos won his first Rocket Richard trophy with 51 goals. None of them were better than this one. What's most impressive to me is batting the puck in one-handed while falling away from the play. Stamkos uses his 6'1" reach plus the entire length of his 5-foot hockey stick to whack this one past Ducks goalie Jonas Hiller. Nothing Hiller could have done to have stopped this one. That is unbelievable. What a goal from Steven Stamkos. Man, those were some awesome goals. Goalies must have been wondering on plays like that, how in the holy hand grenade did he put that puck past me? They gotta be curious about stuff like that. They figure they must have it, the play is dead, and all of a sudden they're looking behind them and it's in the net. Wow, what goals. That was a great top 10. What did you think was the best falling down goal out of that top 10? Was there something I missed perhaps? Please comment. Also, I invite you to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.